We finish another week. I'm thankful for you that you're able to take a few minutes and just spend this time together. And I consider it a great privilege. I trust it's been a good week. Even with trials, it can be a good week if you're trusting the Lord. And we're looking forward to God working this weekend. And again, I would like to ask your prayer as we have 1 week before we start our big Christmas outreach. That goes for 3 weekends. And we're asking God to do a mighty work here. And right in this difficult day, to see many people reach. We can't believe the response that we're getting to this outdoor festival, and certainly we would covet your prayers for that. Well, as we are finishing this time, we need to be encouraged that God is on the move everywhere. All across the world, the gospel is going forward. You got to realize it's not only our country that's going through crisis, it's really the entire world right now. And it has really hindered ministry. But on the other hand, it's furthered many, many ministries. It's been pretty amazing what God has done. And God wants to do the same thing here. In the book of John, we have the apostle finish under inspiration in a very unique way as he shows forth through the different incidents in Christ's life and his teachings, the fact that Jesus is indeed God. He's the Son of God. And he finishes the book this way. This is the disciple which testifieth of these things and wrote these things, and we know that his testimony is true. And there are also many other things which Jesus did, the which, if they should be written every one, I suppose that even the world itself could not contain the books that should be written. Amen. What an ending. He knew of so many things just in the life of Christ here on this earth that weren't written, that it would be just a huge volume of books that would have to be written. That's our Savior. That's just in the 3.5 years of ministry that he had here on this earth. You know, we only have a few of the events of Christ's life. He was constantly doing miracles and working. Now you think of eternity. You think of man's history. It's often been said that history is his story. From Adam and Eve on, God has been on the move. There's been spiritual battle, and there's all kinds of things that have occurred. There have been dark times in history, especially with Israel. There have been bright times of revival. There have been excruciating times of awful conflict. But through it all, God has continued to further his work. And there is no way we could even begin to write the volumes that would have to be written of all the things God is doing, even in 2020. Don't look at life just from man's perspective. Ask God to give you his perspective. God is on the move. He is working. And we need to realize that if we'll pray, we can further God's work, and then if we will do everything God has told us to do, we don't need to just hunker down and not do anything. God has opportunities everywhere. In fact, the crisis with COVID-19, the political crisis, all of these different things can be used as great open doors if we will be very sensitive to what God would have us to do. God is writing another chapter right now. He's writing a chapter through you. You are as important as the Apostle John. I don't care what stage of life you're in. If you are fully yielded to the Lord, God is ready to do great and mighty works. He really is. It's an exciting thing. So as we conclude this week, let's be encouraged. God is working. Jesus did so much in his ministry, and he's continuing on that work right now. He's the head of the church. He is writing new chapters all the time. And may God enable us to be right in the middle of what he is doing.